Okay, we should be back. I have a window capture here. I'm just gonna delete that. Maybe that's why I can't see chat. Browser, ZBrush. Alright, it should be working now. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Had some chat issues for anyone watching this on YouTube. Basically, I just had it hidden. But we're all good now. From all the shenanigans trying to get construction work, construction set to display properly. I managed to get that working last night off stream. So when we do stream, more wind construction set, it should work. I feel like the pectoral spine should be a bit bigger. Maybe they'll act as a rudder, like fins. Don't you add any webbing in between these? Could be nice. I think this pectoral fin should be pretty massive here. And then extend the rest. KKK, have you ever tried making new models for TES3? The low poly sword? Nope. I mean, I could, but I haven't. I believe OpenMW now supports normal maps. So, if someone comes along with the right know-how, they can just make PBR textures for everything in Morrowind. That would be very cool. I don't know if I want to do that. We need to make the fence on the back of the carapace here a bit larger as well now. And give it like a shark fin. People mistake this for like a shark, but it's really something even more terrifying. Does it even look? Looks a bit silly. I don't know if I wanted to do that. That's not. Bit too big. How about let's sculpt this without solo mode. I think this would help me better judge how big these coral fins should be. Maybe it's a bit too thick here. A bit. That looks good. Feel like this rostrum needs to be a bit bigger. Like the whole head area in general needs work. I'll have to work on that. In fact, I think I'll go work on that right now. I've been neglecting the head for way too long. So, number one, I think the rostrum needs to be a bit bigger, longer. I wonder if she'd edit like antenna. How would we go about doing that? Remember that was an idea that I wanted to add, but somehow I decided against it. Let's go hide the mouth for now. And just focus purely. We'll also hide the eyes. I'm gonna focus purely on the on the shell. Maybe these arms right here are a bit wonky. Move stuff around a bit. I need to Dynamesh this mesh soon. And these parts here, I haven't even detailed yet with polypaint. It's like not even done at all. I'm gonna go add this and merge these two together. Then go into solo mode and then start adjusting things around. Want the mouth be a bit larger. I want to make the rostrum thicker. Oops, turn off perspective mode. I'll mask that part. Got this bit here. Also hide that. Now, I think we can just rotate it, can't we? Yeah. Perfect. Want to get some poly paint on this thing, like right now. RGB fill. Then, I don't know, I'll just use a bit of blue or something. Touch up this area here. Okay, that's good enough. Use move. We'll start moving things around. You think it really needs a horn? You can't move fast enough to ram. Real lobsters do swimming pretty fast. I like that we just break. Well, the horn is mostly kind of like a detail I took off of shrimp. Shrimp have that jagged horn, very, very front, called a rostrum. I believe it's called a rostrum. And I don't know. So that was a cool detail to add. Speaking of shrimp, I should probably go I wanna go look at some references for like shrimp or prawn. Prawn, maybe tiger prawns? Pretty sure tiger prawns have some pretty massive rostrums in the front. Has some pretty crazy mouth parts. I really should add antennae to this thing. Maybe some tentacles around the face, too. Yeah. I'm gonna figure out where the net are going to come out from. I'm just gonna use sea spheres for this. How would I animate antennae? That's one of the things I'm not sure of. I guess I can use like maybe some cloth sim for that. I don't actually have to animate all the bones. That'd be kind of a nightmare. It is something I want to figure out how to animate though, so I guess we'll put them in. Can be a real challenge, but I do like challenges. And shrimp have antennae coming out from like the sides of their head. Very interesting location. So I don't know if that would look good from an artistic standpoint. I'm gonna put them coming out from like the right above the eyes, kind of like in like a hornet have its antennae coming out from. That'd be like the base there. Do a dragonfly nymph mouth, it'll take you weeks. Don't doubt it. How would I T-pose antennae? You probably have to be pretty thick, because this is a massive creature. Probably gonna want some pretty thick antennae. I mean, if you look at lobster, they have really thick antennae. Kind of, I guess that would be like the T pose, 45 degree angle. Should be straight ahead though, or I guess it should also be like a 45 degree angle going up. I don't know. I've never T-posed a tendon before, so I'm not entirely sure how to do this. Oh, I'll figure out how to do it later. What the heck? That's so weird. You get your anatomy? What the hell? That looks horrifying. I was just looking at getting sidetracked here, looking at trying to look at references for 1080 pose. That's a T pose for tentacles. Probably the same thing as a tenon. These probably have to be thicker, actually. Like, keeping in mind, lobster have really thick tenon. The Z spheres here. Wow. They really start to look weird if they're separated too far apart. How thick do these have to be? Let's see. That looks like a good width, but then maybe the head's not be able to support that. I have to have like a larger head. Maybe these can like come out from the sides and like horns. I want to look at lobsters. Holy moly. Lobster tentacles are massive. What the heck? They're almost like claws in themselves. At least some types of lobster. All right, so they kind of, it's like a stalk at the end there. All right, so there's like a bit here. And then this is kind of like the base. You have to experiment a bit. See how this will look. From Minecraft villager. Could even have them kind of coming out of the shoulders here. Like at the sides of the head here. In certain lobsters, they're almost like legs. They're very well developed. They're not really attached to the head. I wonder if Atene can rest upon those shoulder wings. Yeah, maybe. That can be interesting. I want to try this out first, though. Yeah, that looks like a good place to have them. But they're gonna clip with the arms. I have to figure out a way to get around that. I'll try the resting on the wings idea. Looks like he's a composer. Rotate them out. Maybe they, what if they're like backwards facing a tenon? I don't know. Just like trailing from the tips here or something. You know, in longhorn beetles, maybe we should look at longhorn beetles and see how those antennae are like. Is I believe in longhorn beetles, their antennae kind of sweep backwards after doing a loop around the front. So I wonder if we maybe do something like that. And it would also remove a bunch of clutter because the front half of the animal is getting very cluttered indeed. We just do this. I think this would work. It's just one of those things you have to experiment with. Hi, Nayan. What are those? These would be antennae. I don't know, I'm just kind of experimenting with having them in the first place. I'm not 100% sure how they'll look. I don't know if I should have them back facing or front facing, or if I should even have them at all. I want to at least put in the effort to see if it's something worthwhile to add. That could be pretty good. I feel like maybe we shouldn't have a 10A. I think it's already a bit of a complex model already. It looks good enough without them. I don't know if they add too much to the. Yeah, the whole antenna thing is a bit too much. Makes the crew look too Earth-like. Well, not just that, it's just like. I just feel like there's like too much stuff going on already. If I add the 10 a 10A, it's just gonna be a bit too much. And like your eyes are gonna go everywhere. For the person viewing this artwork, and be like, oh, what should I look at first? It's already a ton of stuff that you have to look at. Oops. Like that. Okay, so yeah, let's just go. Yeah, this face actually isn't that bad. I think we'll just expand on this and just make it a bit better, and then we'll settle with this. Even though we didn't add a 10A, I think it was worthwhile to at least explore the idea of having them. There's always these forward-facing spines. You'll see this on shrimp with their rostrum. They have forward-facing spines on the front here. I guess sort of like a defense, right? It's mostly defense than offense. Well, I'm not 100% sure what the function is. Could just be more cosmetic. Look cool. I know if I was like a shrimp, I'd want a spiky rostrum. Yeah, the corals are just like they aren't instant mesh. But they are they're just like normal meshes. I just duplicated and placed around. Yeah, they are a placeholder for now. Oh. Whoa, I don't like the look of that. What the heck? That's like he looks like he has some sort of buzz haircut now for some reason. Wait, did he always look like that? Awesome. This part up here. Okay, let's go all the way to the end. And we'll just fix that a bit. That looks a bit odd. Maybe it's just like the shadow being cast down. Kind of looks like he has like some sort of bizarre looking crown in the front. How to not make look stupid. Yeah, let's pull this in. No. kind of like the look of that actually. It'll give it kind of like a fierce, regal look in the front. You know, like how lionfish look? You know, I kind of want to give it a bit of a lionfish appearance. It look a bit intimidating. Maybe like frogfish. Give it that very shocking look. First, we'll do the same for his cheekbones, which is his cheek plate. Non-counter one. I forgot I made coffee here. I should have some before it gets cold anyway. Sorry, like lukewarm coffee. Yeah, we'll just work on the face. Now you'll notice I'm kind of giving it humanistic features. Like I am saying like cheek. You guys caught me saying cheekbone a while back. That's because I do kind of want to give it somewhat relatable characteristics. So it has like a cheekbone here and also a brow. You'll notice this in like a ton of monster and creature designs that we humans sort of kind of superimpose our biological design onto like fantasy creatures like all the time. For instance, like dragons are usually very intelligent and can speak and do like magic in D&D settings. Goblins, orcs, elves, etc. are all just like humans with different colored skin. And of course, you'll find the furry community has a lot of this. But we don't talk about those people. Easier to make rule 34 that way. Add glowing eyes. Yeah, I was thinking about like doing something with bioluminescence. Maybe even some of the coral will glow. There's all sorts of ways, all sorts of methods we can utilize to enhance the appearance of our fellow crab. I want to give it some more spikes on the head here. Maybe like a crown of spikes. kind of want, I need to like extend this crest, I think, to give it kind of like a triceratops crest. Maybe not that exaggerated as a triceratops, but you'll see what I mean in a bit. I do like this forward-facing spine here. I think some rhinoceros beetles have this particular detail. I kind of want to enhance it a bit more. Maybe make it a bit bigger. Although it does look pretty nice as is. Man, there's like a party upstairs or something. I don't know if you guys can hear it. People are like dancing and putting on some Friday night vibes. Second, be right back. Shit, what is going on upstairs? A snack. Snacks in. All right, I'm back. Yeah, I'm eating on stream. Sue me. These spines here will have to be swept back a bit. This part here I can pull out more, forward more a bit. Else can I do? I don't know. Night. Maybe you should curl that horn up a bit and make it thicker. Which one? Like the one coming from the front or? Maybe I can give it like a slight curl. I don't know. Maybe. See how that would go. That could look good. Be something like that. I think I might just leave it straight. Yeah, I think I might just leave that one straight. Oops. Like that beetle. Nah, I think I want to keep it straight. This is gonna be like gonna be a very kind of based off of a shrimp. So I do kind of want to keep it straight. Maybe even make it longer. Could add like a slight curve. Yeah, it's like a slight curve here. A lot of areas, avenues I can take this design. Even tip it off entirely. Hey, that looks pretty good. I might actually go with that. I'll have to make the head a little bit larger, I think, on the sides. Curve looks good. I figure out maybe. Look even better. And maybe this up. I think I can even clip it down a bit further. I think I'll go without a horn actually. Because you know, shrimp are fast animals. I feel like the horn is part of that very fast, sleek design. But over time, this design has gotten more and more bulky and more slow. So I'm thinking that the horn doesn't make as much sense anymore. This is more like a brutish, kind of like a slow battle tank, really. So if the horn was in the way, it wouldn't be able to really eat all too well. I don't know. I think this looks a bit better. We can still have like a few interesting horn details around on the head. Then maybe I'll copy that detail there and put it on the shoulders here so he has nice big spiky shoulders. I think that's a good mode of operation. Yeah. Sometimes less is more, huh? Let's go move this up a bit. Move the claws up a bit as well. Yeah, a bit too high. Or maybe I just need to rotate them up instead. Whoops. Symmetry is on. There. You can even make the joints a bit thicker now because there's more room. Let's go ahead and do that. Think we should probably rotate them right now. Is it a bit too high up? We need stronger looking shoulders. I'm gonna go work on that. One second, guys. I'm gonna finish these crackers. I'm gonna mute myself for a bit. Okay, I'm back. We can even make, I think we can even make this part here too. Is pulling some of the scutes forward. Don't know if they're called scutes since this isn't a tortoise, but I mean they're fairly similar, so I'm just gonna call them scutes. It's looking a bit thin there. I'll have to go back up with the inflate brush, be a bit more sturdy. Basic premise is to make the shoulders larger, more spiky, more badass. Kind of gives me like manta ray vibes. If a manta ray was a was crossbred with a lobster. Let's add maybe a few scoots to the top too. Spikes. She's on, yeah. There should be a line going around through here, isn't there? How is this attached to and such? Moving all the geometry outwards a bit because we have neglected the top part of this carapace for a long time. We're finally getting to it. We're too focused on the legs. Everything else, okay, I lost sight of top half of the carapace. This is a very interesting plate. I'm going to have to see how this articulates. Kind of want to be able to raise its arms up. I guess this plate will help facilitate that, but I do have to. That means I do have to move it a bit closer. Head. Squash a few of the details in here. Probably not too much. Now I should be able to raise his arms up and down using this joint here. This will kind of bring out its shoulders a bit more too. And see how that looks. Not too bad. Kind of want to bring this down a bit. I feel like the wings kind of have an unnatural shape to them. I should bring them down a bit more. Have them a bit curved around so. It's more of like a shell, and less like some sort of anime hairstyle. Undo a few of this. I think I got a bit ahead of myself in terms of moving the details around. That looks a bit better. It was kind of good as is. But still, something feels a bit weird about it. This part should move down a bit. There's a huge depression here. I think I should draw that out. Just so there's more room for muscle. I don't know why I didn't catch that. It's like kind of a massive oversight on my part. Looks like balls. We'll have to fix that. Let's go and use, I want to say standard, but maybe we should use clay buildup for this. think I was being a bit too optimistic when I said I can finish this sculpt in the 2 hours we have today. Man, every day we're making this a little bit better, day by day. That's better. Although it is looking a bit too swole. Let's tighten that up a bit. Bit too bulky. Just a bit too bulky. Oh. What's that, yawn counter number two? I feel like I must have yawned before then, right? At least 3 yawns? I don't know. Do I plan to add this to my ArtStation portfolio? You betcha. Yep. Definitely gonna add it there. Always good to post your stuff online. Internet karma points are worth real life money. Everyone knew that. Right, looking good. Looking good, looking good. Little bit too small. Bit you chubby, chubby rubby rubby. Should we do now? What do you say, Mr. Krabs? Give you a new haircut. We should give Krabs a quarantine haircut. How's the virus in Malaysia? It's doing good. Think there's like less people infected per day. We're kind of on like the downward trend of the curve. But everyone's saying that the virus is going to come back eventually, so see about that. These spikes are a little bit too extreme. I think this had to do with like the horn in the front too. This is more of like a streamline shape for a more streamlined crab that we were designing, but this is gonna be more of a chunky pink crab. We'll tone that back just a bit. One second, you're back. All right, I'm back. Oh my God, why does that keep happening? I wonder when the new Witcher series is coming out. Toss a coin to your Witcher. Song stuck in my head. I'm gonna use some Damien standard actually. I haven't really used any other brush this entire stream except for like move brush. What series again? The Witcher 3 series. Or, well, the Rich Witcher series, not Witcher 3. It's on Netflix. Might actually be out already, I don't know. I haven't checked in a long time. Oh, speaking of weedsmen, what's that? You trying to type in Witcher, but then turn him out as weedsman? You seen that Polish fan movie? I don't think so. That sounds very obscure. Is this Polish fan movie related to The Witcher? Oh. What's that, the fourth yawn? Third or fourth, one or the other. Maybe the legs are a bit too big. I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, I think the legs are might actually be a tiny bit too big. This creature. I'm gonna go T-pose this. After that, though, I think it's a good time to and the stream after T-Pain's. I want to get some gaming done. It's the weekend, yo. I think it's not working. T-pose. Transpose. There. T-pose complete. I feel like the legs are just a tiny bit too big. You can just like scale it down by a minuscule amount. I think it'll look a bit nicer. There we go. Okay, cool. Let's go do the T-pose. So what? Wow, this is taking a while. Oh. It'll T-pose eventually. Still T-posing. Yeah, right. Local crab resists being forced into T pose. Maybe it's because of like how much undo history there is. I don't know. I have to see. Maybe I bumped up the undo history a bit too much. It was like this before. This happened before, remember, guys? I did like T pose a while back and it took this long. Oh my God, this is taking forever. I could have just like done it individually to each leg and it would have taken like a fifth of the time, even less. God, I'm tempted to just like Alt F4 out of ZBrush and just do it manually. Yeah, auto save. I'll wait though. All right, well, I'm gonna just end the stream here. I'll eventually get out of T pose, but I don't want the YouTube video to be insanely long, so. All I don't think it's the stream's fault. I think it's maybe it has to do with like how many undo levels there are, or something else. Anyway, yeah, I'll talk to you guys later. I was thinking about doing like some more wind modding, but on second hand thought, I think I'll just play like some Terraria and chill or something. Yeah, I'll see you guys next week. And yeah, till then, have a good one, guys.